Hello, in this video I'll be explaining the basics of C++ and QML integration. Before watching this video, you should ensure that you are familiar with QML, C++, and QCreator. If you are not, then we have a number of other tutorial videos to help get you up to speed. I've already created a basic QML application with a simple GUI as shown. The goal of this application will be to generate a random number in C++ between the two numbers selected in the combo boxes. I will also be tracking how many numbers have been generated using a property in C++. Since the QML for the UI has already been created, the first thing we'll need to do is create our C++ class, which will eventually be exposed to QML. So I'll right-click on Source Files, click Add New, select C++ Class, and click Choose. On the next screen, I'll provide a name for my class, calling it Backend to keep it generic. I will also set the base class to QObject, as this will be needed to expose it to QML. I'll then click Next. Finally, we come to the summary page, which will summarize what will be created and where. Nothing needs to be changed here, so I'll click Finish. Our class has been created, but in order to view it from the Project Explorer, we must add it to the cmakelist.txt file, so I'll navigate there now. Here, we need to add the C++ sources, so in Qt add QML module, I'll add sources, which is used to add the non-QML sources to the module. Then, I'll add both the header and implementation files. Note the URI, which is defined as CPP integration. This will eventually be used to import the module which contains the C++ sources into our QML file. Now, when we save this file, we will see our C++ header and implementation files appear in the Project Explorer on the left. With this done, we can now start to flesh out our class, so I'll navigate to backend.h. The first thing we need to do is include Qt QML in our project, so I will add include Qt QML. This will provide us with the QML element macro, which will allow us to register the C++ class as a QML type. So I'll add that now, adding QML underscore element underneath the QObject macro. With that done, we can now add our function to generate the random number. However, since we want this function to be callable from QML, we will need to define it with the QInvocable macro. This macro will make any C++ function callable in the QML instance. It is worth mentioning that in addition to QInvocables, all slots defined in C++ classes defined as QML elements will be exposed to QML as methods in a similar manner to QInvocables. But in this case, I will use a QInvocable. So, I will add the following. Next, I want to add a signal which will emit the number we generate with this function. This signal will automatically be available to QML without any other additions. So I will add void number emitted int num. We are now ready to implement our function, so I will highlight my function and refactor it. This function is going to be straightforward, as it will just take the bounds of our random number and generate a number based on them. So I will add const int rand num equals q random generator global bounded by the min and the max. Then we want to emit the signal, which will take the random number we generated as an argument. So I will add emit number emitted and give it random. With that done, our function is now ready to be used in QML. So I will navigate to my main.qml file. Now, the first thing we need to do here is import the module which contains our C++ class into the QML file. So I'll import using the URI, which was defined in the cmakelist.txt file. So I'll add import cpp integration. With this added, we are now ready to create our QML type, which is based on our C++ class. Doing this, we'll also create an instance of our C++ class. So I'll add backend and give it the ID my backend. As you can see, this component has the same name as our C++ class, and since we defined it using QML element, we can create an instance of it in QML, as if it were any other component. We are going to be tracking the value of the random number we generate using the QML property randNum. So we are going to need to update this property every time the number emitted signal is emitted from C++. So I will add a signal handler to the instance of backend, which will update the value of randNum. So I will add on number emitted num randNum equals num. Now we simply need to call our generate number function when we click the button. So I will add a call to that function to the onClick signal handler of the button. My backend dot generate number, give it low value dot current value and high value dot current value. Now if I run my application, we can see that we are successfully able to generate numbers between the values in the combo box. Now that we have the random number generator working, the next thing I would like to add is the ability to track how many numbers have been generated using a property inside our C++ class. To do this, let's move to our backend header file. Here we are going to define our property using the queue property macro, so I will add that now. Queue properties must be defined in a specific way to function properly. There are several ways that this can be done depending on your needs. For my example, I'm going to set this up in a relatively simple way to make it as understandable as possible, but understand this is not the only way to define a queue property. I will set this up using the member and notify keywords. The member keyword will reference a member variable of my class, which means I need to create a member variable to store the property's value. So I'll do that now. Int m underscore numbers generated equals 0. The notify keyword will reference a signal which will be emitted anytime the property is modified from QML. This notify signal is required for the property to function, so I will add that signal as well. Void update to numbers generated. With these added, we can now finish creating our queue property. The property will be defined in three parts. The first part defines the variable type and variable name. So I will add int numbers generated. So our property will be of the integer type and be called numbers generated. When making your own properties, then you can of course customize the variable type and name as needed. Next, we will add the member keyword, which will need to reference our member variable. So I will add m underscore numbers generated to match the name of our member variable. This member variable will store the value of the queue property and will be able to modify it directly from QML through the name of the queue property. Finally, we will add notify, which will reference the name of our signal. So I will add notify, update to numbers generated. This signal will now be emitted when our Q property is modified from QML. However, it has not yet been connected to anything, and therefore, we should add a slot which will connect to this signal. So, I'll add public slots void on update to numbers generated. With this added, I will highlight it, right-click, and refactor to add an implementation to the slot. I will keep it simple here and just print out a message to inform the user that the property has successfully been updated. So I'll add QInfo property updated in backend. Finally, I just need to add one thing to the constructor. I will connect my notify signal from my Q property to the slot I just created by adding Q object connect this backend update to numbers generated this backend on update to numbers generated. With that done, our Q property is ready to be used in QML. So I will navigate to my main.qml file. Here I am now able to use the Q property I defined in C++ in QML. So I'll add some code to increment the value of this Q property anytime the button is clicked by adding my backend.numbers generated plus plus. Finally, I would like to display the value of this property on the screen, so I will add some code to do that. My backend.numbers generated. With this done, our program should be fully functional, so let's go ahead and run it. As you can see, we are now tracking the number of numbers we've generated. You can also see that we got a message on the console which indicated that the Q property is being updated in C++. This completes our application and our explanation of the basics of C++ and QML integration. This only covers some of the ways this can be done. For a deeper dive into the topic, I highly recommend looking at the documentation linked in the description. If you ran into any issues along the way, feel free to create a support ticket through your Qt account and we'll be sure to help you resolve your issue. Thank you.